So earlier we have seen things related to isoentropic flow and mass flow rate equation. So now we are going to study a very important condition of choking. This happens in lot of equipments there where we have fluid flow and pressure reduction or increase is happening. And let's look at this. What's the problem in choking? So in converging type of nozzle, we cannot have increase in mass flow rate once we have reached Mach number is equal to 1. So once we have reached critical condition in a converging type of nozzle, we cannot increase the mass flow rate. So that is a very large result. Even though we are going to increase the pressure ratio, because we know that increasing the pressure ratio will have effect on the mass flow rate. So even if we are going to increase or decrease the pressure ratio, the mass flow rate is not going to change. So this is very important and strong condition which we are claiming right now. And that is, at mass flow rate is equal to 1, at nozzle exit, the mass flow rate becomes maximum. Or even if it is not at nozzle exit, it becomes Mach number is equal to 1 at any point inside the flow region. So if we have a converging type of nozzle, and at any cross section, if we have mass flow rate, Mach number is equal to 1, that is, from here on, the whatever pressure reduction or increase we are taking place into account, that is useless to us. Whatever pressure ratio is between these two cross section, that is giving to give us the mass flow rate and all other condition. And whatever pressure ratio we have, or whatever change in the cross section we are having, we are not going to increase the mass flow rate. So that is of no use for us. And reservoir P, so we have a reservoir, we have a nozzle. This is the nozzle. And over here we have wall, and that is the outlet for us. So reserve properties are given as P0, T0, rho 0. And this is the PE point, E point. This is PB, that is the back pressure. And it is open to atmosphere. That's why it is P atmospheric. So we know in the reservoir, the pressure should be larger. After the nozzle, the pressure is smaller. Or we have atmospheric pressure generally. So P0 is P is greater than P atm. And hence, the flow will happen from higher pressure to lower pressure. That's what it's happening. P0 is the static or stagnation pressure, whatever you want to think of it is right now. So if the fluid is at rest in the reservoir, the static pressure will convert to stagnation pressure directly, or stagnation properties directly. So let's look at this. So when these are same, they are being repeated, so it's more in detail over here. So when P exit is equal to P star, so P exit was over here. This is the exit point for the nozzle. And V exit is equal to A, that is the velocity of sound in air. We have the condition of Mach number is equal to 1 or critical flow. So there isn't increase in mass flow rate. So what it does, it means practically, that means when my pressure is equal to constant in all positions, that is exit pressure, back pressure, and reservoir pressure are same, my mass flow rate is equal to B0, because there is no pressure gradient in my flow region. Hence, the mass flow rate will be 0. When my reservoir pressure is higher, but my back pressure and exit pressure are lower, there will be some flow. When I reduce the pressure, that means I am increasing the pressure ratio, the mass flow rate is going to increase. So this is mass flow rate is 0, mass flow rate is increasing. And when I'm still decreasing, and my pressure PB and P exit is equal to 200, I'm still increasing the mass flow rate. But when a point of time occurs, point of flow in a somewhere occurs in the my flow region, where my back pressure is my back pressure can be anything, but my exit pressure becomes critical. Then after that, so I can have an extra line from here, which shows that my exit pressure has become this shows my exit pressure has become P critical. So that is this line. So let me redraw. So this is my straight line. Let me use another color. So that's all. So when my exit pressure becomes critical pressure, my mass flow rate will not increase. What does that mean is, if I'm going to have a critical pressure line over like that, if I'm going to increase the pressure gradient faster, I can do something like this. I can reach mass flow rate, maximum mass flow rate, and then my mass flow rate will become same. So hence the pressure from that point of time in the nozzle. So if my mass flow rate is maximum over here, I have achieved Mach number is equal to 1. My pressure will remain constant till I exit. And then back pressure can be different, but that can be devastating result if my back pressure is higher than the pressure over here. I can have a reversal flow. So the design of these things are very critical. The nozzle and diffuser. And the same thing can occur with velocity, with respect to velocity also. So I would explain the same thing with pressure. Similar will be occurring with velocity. So after I have achieved a velocity is equal to velocity of sound in air, that is my Mach number is 1. I can achieve that with a faster flow, but when I achieve Mach number is equal to 1, I cannot have larger velocities. So that is the condition of choking. This is the practical problem with choking. And let's look at the statement. So my PB is less than P star, then there is a shock formation. So when my back pressure, that was the pressure just before my fluid was exiting from the fluid reserve, that is the back pressure is less than the critical pressure, then there is shock formation. That is, we are moving from higher or supersonic to subsonic region. There is a pressure wave, that is shock wave. And my exit pressure remains P star. So everywhere in my flow regime in the nozzle, the pressure will remain constant. That is P exit is equal to P star. We experience choking and no further increase in mass flow rate, even if my back pressure is reduced. So I have reduced back pressure. That means the pressure gradient has increased, but that increase in pressure gradient is not going to help me out. So this is the thing, the mass flow rate is constant and it is not going to increase even if my pressure gradient increases. So my pressure gradient is 1, and if I keep on increasing the pressure gradient, so it is opposite, the pressure gradient is increasing in this direction. If I increase the pressure gradient, the mass flow rate will increase till 1 point, and when the choking occurs, that is my critical conditions are occurring in my flow regime in the nozzle, my mass flow rate is constant. I'm not going to have an increasing mass flow rate later. So this is not achieved. So that's all. We'll stop over here. In the next video, we'll look at some numerical problem.